I would like to demonstrate how the browser handles form data. Here we have two text boxes, a password box, a group of radio buttons, a text area, a submit button, and a reset button. If you look at the HTML code, my form tag has an action attribute, but there is no value. Typically, the value of the action attribute will be the name of the server script that will process the form data. If that is missing, it will actually just send the data from the form to itself. Here I have a text box and a corresponding label element. Notice my text box has both a name and an ID attribute. The ID attribute is used for JavaScript and for CSS, and it also associates the label element with this form element for purposes of accessibility. The name attribute is used to uniquely identify this form element for the server. So every one of my form elements will have a unique name attribute. That name attribute will be paired with a value that the user either will enter or check, and that will be sent to the server for processing. Notice in the case of radio buttons, because they are mutually exclusive, meaning only one can be checked at a time, they all have the same value for the name attribute. When I click the button that is coded with type equals submit, the action of the form is called and the name value pairs are sent to the server. So every form element is coded in with a name attribute. The user will type in a value, or the user may check a value. When I click submit, you will notice in the address bar that the data is being posted back to the form, and you can see the actual name value pairs being sent over. Notice name equals value ampersand. Name equals value ampersand. Name equals value ampersand. That is the syntax. These name value pairs are being sent somewhere, ideally to the server, but in our case, they are just being posted back to the form. Now, notice our form tag does not have a method. Therefore, the default method is a get. The get will send the name value pairs in the address bar or the header of the message, as we have just seen. Suppose I were to click reset form and I clear out my form fields. Now I'm going to submit the form data again. Notice I have no data. However, notice what is sent. Fname equals nothing. Ampersand lname equals nothing. Ampersand pw equals nothing. Ampersand comments equal nothing. Text boxes and text areas by default contain emptiness, and that will be sent to the server. Radio buttons and check boxes, on the other hand, need to be checked in order for data to be sent. Notice there are no radio boxes up here. If I were to check one and click submit, now I see gender equals female. Now I have entered some strange data in my comment box. I have an apostrophe, an ampersand, some quotations, a percent, and a dollar sign. If I were to submit that data, notice how it is transferred. Some of our characters are encoded. Blank spaces are represented by a plus sign. However, my other characters are encoded. This is the character encoding. So when data is sent to the server, some special characters will be encoded. I have added a drop-down list. By default, the first choice in a drop-down list is selected by default. So when I click the Submit button, you see that the value for my drop-down list will be returned. I have now added an action to my form, and this is a PHP script running on this server. Notice the method by default is still a GET. If I were to try to submit the data, I do access the PHP page. I do access the PHP page, as you can see in the address bar, and I can see that my name value pairs have been sent. However, there is no information here. That is because PHP scripts usually are developed in order to work with either a POST or a GET, not necessarily both. So in this case, I need to use method equals POST. Now that I have added method equals POST to my form tag, I will now fill out the form again. Notice I have filled out the password field also, and you cannot see what I have entered. When I submit the data, I now see my name value pairs being displayed on this page. That was accomplished using this PHP script. The purpose of that is just to assist you in identifying the values for your form elements. Notice we see test, which is what I entered in the password box. So HTML forms need to be processed by a script on the server in order to retrieve the values that the user has entered. Every form element will be identified with a name attribute so that we can match the response with the correct form element. So in our form tag, the action is a very important attribute, and the method is a very important attribute. When the user clicks the button, input type equals submit, it will call the action of the form using the method to send the data, and the name value pairs will be sent to the server.